Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, wherever you are. And we're back for another video. So I've been doing a bit more of the realistic tanks lately, trying to level up the Panther D. So I ran the 5.7 level for the Germans. Had a good match in that the other day, one I enjoyed quite a lot. So I wanted to talk you guys through it. Started off a little way through the match and I went out first in the Panther D. Been trying to go out in the Panther D more. I like the tank. It's obviously its main failing is its hand crank turret. I think it's pretty much one of the slowest turrets in the game. It's painfully slow. But it can take the hits. Unfortunately, was up-tiered in this game. In this game it was Germans versus Allies, so the other team has both American and Russian tanks. And whilst we have a couple of Tiger IIs and a couple of Jag Panthers, that's pretty much it. The enemy team does in fact start off with multiple M26 Pershings, multiple T-44s, whole bunch of IS-2s, where in fact most of our team is Tiger H1s and Panther Ds like me. So we are starting off on the back foot here. This is going to be an uphill battle. Found my spot here. I've noticed some shooting going on the river there, so I'm going to take a look. Quite see just yet. Oh, there's one. What is it? Looks like an IS. Oh, well, it was an IS. It was an IS-2. There's a Pershing of some description going off in the background there as well. Very speculative shot. Oh, and a long range shot from an SU-100 actually over there. Another very dangerous tank, particularly to a Panther D. He's hit me again, so I'm going to retreat behind this rock. He's taking out my gunner and my turret like a cheeky boy. It's always good to get into a match and have your repair-a-thon straight away. The better thing about being in a lower tier of a match is that you probably have to do less to actually get a second spawn. So you don't have to kill. I've already killed one tank and it's a higher level tank than me, although not by much. So I'm probably reasonably assured of a second spawn. The SU-100's still there. Take a shot. And I hit him, but just after he gets obliterated by a Tiger II. So I don't actually get anything for that, which is a little bit frustrating. This could be a pretty reasonable spot, and there's other guys around me, so I should be reasonably safe. I can hear something in the background now that I'm listening to it on the recording, and I did not hear it at the time. The action is the planes flying over there, and yep, that was in fact a T-44. And even without critical damage, there's absolutely no way, unless I had the element of surprise, I was going to be able to deal with a T-44. That's the easiest kill of that guy's life. Yes, AZF-357. We shall remember him because we'll see some more of him later. And there he is. Just waiting to respawn now. He's choosing which tank. Okay, he's trying to mate with my tank, apparently. I don't know. Bit of a necrophiliac, he likes to mate with dead tanks. Slightly weird. We won't talk about that anymore. And judging by the motto on the side of his tank, he's doing it all for the motherland as well. Including the weird tankness that he was engaging in there. So I'm going to spawn in Old Faithful here, because I do enjoy this tank despite the fact that it is drastically under-tiered here. That guy behind me is in fact my teammate. Or squad mate, in a random squad. And he's just shot down a plane, but he has been damaged and he is having to repair. So I thought to myself, you know what, he's my squad mate. I'll go back and I'll help him repair. It did look like he was going to have quite a long repair time in this. So it's the nice thing to do. And you know, I'm sure they don't get too many strangers helping them out. So by this point we are well and truly getting our asses kicked. There's a guy on the other team called Gary Tuller, and he is driving around in T-34-100 kicking the asses of all our lower tier tanks. So he's kicking puppies, as they would say. You see, a lot of Gary Tuller has killed Panther D's, and Gary Tuller has killed Tiger H1s, not Panther H1s. What are you saying, mate? And it's pretty much really turning into a defensive game here. I'm not going to be pressing forwards anymore. I can see fire going off to the side here, and what's coming out? There's definitely something there. Oh, it's an IS-1. Take a shot at him. Oh dear, there's two. Get a shot in quickly. Okay, that's a critical paralyzing hit on that guy, so we don't have to concentrate for him for a while. Snapshot bounced off the side of that guy's turret. I've already damaged him. Been hit from the side, but nothing. He's given me the weak point. You always want to aim at those slightly flat weak points on the side. Same shot into there, and that is two IS-1s to my name. KV-1B is actually a pretty good match for those sort of tanks. I would happily take it up against those. It's certainly got the gun for it. And I'm moving back to defend our spawn now, but I can see something approaching in the background there. And I think our Ostwind here knows it, and from what I could see, it was a T-44. And that's not really a very good situation for me. Technically and realistic, it's only one battle rating higher than me, but simulator battle puts it at 6.7, and the T-44 is easily capable of dealing with Tiger 2s. There he is. As far as I'm concerned, I'm pretty much firing in vain here, because I'm never expecting to survive a battle with a T-44. And then those two shots bounced from him there. I've maybe got one slight chance.
You weak, pathetic fool.
I thought I'd bring in a bit of Shao Kahn there just to say how embarrassed he must have been.
You are nothing.
And that's the power of the KV-1B. T-34 had no chance there. Don't know what the guy was bringing a T-34 STZ into this match for, because he managed to make it all the way up here. Shoot at that guy just before he dies. I get crucified by the Pershing in the background. That is the guy I probably should have been shooting at. And all this time there has actually been somebody shooting at me in the trees over to the left there, which looks like I've been ignoring, but actually I just haven't really noticed. So, should really have paid more attention. Right, turret's back working again. But it's too late. Oh dear, Immortal Hun. See, Immortal Hun is in fact driving an American tank. Doesn't quite make sense. But yeah, Pershing is gonna be able to knock me out with relative ease. But I think the KV-1B did its job well, served me well. And that leaves me with my one remaining tank, my trusty Tiger H1. Again, somewhat outclassed in this match, but what are you going to do? We need to defend the cap hard now, because there's very few people left. One of our guys has been out there really kicking some serious ass in his Tiger H1. Oh dear, getting shot. Oh, and there's Gary Tuller. And it's T-34-100.
Is that your best?
I added that little soundbite in because that is in fact a T-44 shooting me there. and he had two shots against the back of my Tiger H1 and failed to really give me any significant damage, and that's pretty poor. So that's two T-44s that should be embarrassed with their performance. I would be very, very upset with myself if I was a T-44 driver and I failed to kill a KV-1B and in fact got killed by a KV-1B. That is terrible. I'm struggling to see where this T-44 has gone now. I know he's over there, but I need to protect my mate in the Kugelblitz here. Oh, he's back. And once again, he somehow found, I don't know if he's run out of ammo and is just firing high explosive at me or something, because it's really not doing any damage, and the T-44 is most definitely capable of damaging a Tiger. He's just behind the bush there, and I spot him. I hit the ground. He's piling shots into me, but he's just not doing any damage. And I do struggle to believe that somebody would have got to the level of driving a T-44 and not know how to shoot at a Tiger and where its weak spots are, because it has very glaringly obvious frontal weak spots. Come on, Kugel. Let's get him. There he is. He's sat there. We can get him. We can finish off this T-44. It's a tall order. It is a tall order from the front. You've got to get them on the perfect spot either side of the gun barrel. And I'm bouncing shots like nobody's business here. And I really have no business to still be alive, but this T-44 driver, who's now dead, and it was in fact Azef. Azef 357, so I've got my revenge against him. Lord knows what he was doing. Maybe he was in fact incredibly lucky to just catch me at that position in the Panther D. I think that is what happens when you're facing out to the left, or to the right even, and you're not really watching the arse of your tank. A random floating fire there, sort of bugs you get in the replays. And there's our man E.T. Payne. He was the superstar of this match for us. He had in fact so many kills in this match that he managed to get a hell of a lot of spawns. And the Kugelblitz I was protecting back there, he's going to follow me back to protect our spawn. It's basically just the three of us left now. And there's a good six or seven of the enemy team left, so we are making essentially a desperate last stand. He's in a Panther D, another 5.7 tank, and we're in a 6.7 match. I'm in a 5.7 tank. The Kugelblitz, I don't think, is even that. And we see the IS-2 coming in the background, and that is in fact Gary Tuller again. Got something behind there as well. God knows what. Some kind of anti-aircraft of the enemy team firing there. I'm firing over this hill to see if I can track Gary's movements. Gary is in fact the team's nemesis on this. Gary and... I did see him there going to the left. And it's a guy called Colon or Corlon in the Kugelblitz behind us that's trying to protect us both desperately from air fire. It's just a waiting game now, and they could be coming at us from the left or the right, so we've really got to be on our toes. E.T. Payne's gone up onto the hill. That AAA is still there firing over the other side. Ooh, what's that? It's a Jackson. I initially thought it was... I set him on fire. I initially thought it was a Sherman. A bit of a replay bug here because I'm not spazzing out the gun like that. Getting quite a few shots into him here. These American tank destroyers, they're basically made of air and you just shoot through them so easily. There he is. There's Gary Tuller. Bad shot went past the back of his turret, but we're going to get another opportunity here. And that is a paralyzing, crippling shot. And he's just been finished off as well. Oh, and we've got... Is that? I never know whether that's an M19 or an M42. Artillery coming in as well, but I'm not moving. I want to get rid of that tank. And he dies. Oh, I get an assist on him. And that is my game up, because I only use three tanks. So that leaves us with Corlon here. And with E.T. Payne. And I'm going to... I carried on watching this match. E.T. Payne's just died in his first Panther, but he's got a respawn in the Panther. Carried on watching this match because I was invested in this now. This felt like a real battle to the death, a last heroic stand, like the Zulus or the Alamo. It's the two of them now, and the amount of time that these guys last out is mental. And there's Azef again in his winter camo IS-2, and this guy came in and caused a lot of problems. He's just killed Corlon in the Kugelblitz, so ET's going to try and take advantage, because the IS-2s do have fairly long reload time, and he's not even looking in the right direction here. Let's plant a shot into him. I don't actually know anymore how much these shots damage the tanks, because it's not me firing them. But he's going to edge forward and take another shot, and apparently he did not damage the IS-2 enough. And he's taking a big hit there, and he really needs some help right now. Which is a good thing, because Corlon's just spawned in a D9. And that's quite a sizable bomb he's got beneath him there, so ET really needs to just hold out. Hold out, defend the cap circle. This is a battle match. It's Mozdok, for anybody that hasn't realised. And this is a battle match. So if they cap our point, the game is over. But it will take them a long time to cap our point. So they've already decapped, or, you know, taken our ownership of it away, and we've capped it back. ET is going to try and go around the side and bury himself into the ground. What's going on? Oh, some special War Thunder lag there. Ah, and there's that Jackson from earlier. Corlon's now arrived on the scene, but it's too late. It's too late to save ET, but he can still get Azer. I'm not sure he can see him through the smoke, and he sees him last minute and nearly pancakes it. Doesn't quite hit him. And this is realistic, so his bomb's not going to respawn. I don't know whether he actually managed to damage the IS-2 or not. But ET knows exactly where he is now. He's actually heading there towards those rocks to maybe try and camouflage his white tank against those rocks. God knows why he chose the snow camo. It wasn't enough, though. The ET takes him out, and the Panzer 470V, or 475, is actually a pretty solid little tank. Especially if you get one of these head-on, they can be a real pain. We know the Jackson's around here somewhere as well. And we've all put several shots into him. Oh, and he's up on the hill. He's taking a shot, but he bounces. Oh, he certainly doesn't do crippling damage. And it's only a matter of time now. ET's going to get him. And he successfully defended our cap from the current two aggressors. He needs to get back into position now quickly. Ready. It was Azef that caused us a lot of problems earlier. He's now gone from the area. But Gary Tuller is not, and he's come back. He's obviously had a second spawn in his IS-2, and he's made his way over here. The nemesis of the team. Gary does, in fact, end the game with 10 kills. ET's got himself another Panzer 470, though, and he should know roughly where Gary is. Old Gary boy there, so let's see if he can do anything about it. During this time I was actually watching the whole match, and I couldn't talk to these guys because I wasn't in the squad with them. I couldn't talk to them verbally, but I was typing to them all the time, trying to help them out, watching around their tanks, trying to give them clues as to where the enemy were coming from, because I mean, they were already outnumbered enough as it was, and they were in lower ranked tanks. And I was telling ET here that he's not going to get any support from Corlun, because Corlun's got problems of his own at the moment. He's actually being engaged by two enemy planes. There he is. He's got a P-47 and an LA-7B-20 on him. Oh, those are both planes you definitely want to have tailing you. He's desperately trying to engage them in a turning battle. The P-47's on his tail, but the LA-7B is just swooping in and taking passing runs at him. And this sort of tactic, it's not going to last forever. And there he is, Mr. Batchat. He's got something out of this match, because it was in fact Mr. Batchat. Ooh, and there he goes. Bang. That was in fact Mr. Batchat that came out in his T-44 and got killed by me in the KV-1B, so he's managed to salvage some level of dignity from this, but he'll never live that down. Certainly not now if this goes on YouTube, and if people see it, he will never live it down. I won't allow it. He should definitely have killed me there. Oh dear, and it's Gary Tuller again. What are we going to do? Can we get this guy? It's pretty much all over now. Corlun's just got a Panzer 3 left. I think it's a Panzer 3L. That's pretty much what we're down to with Corlun. And poor old E.T. He's just here in his Ostwind. But he's going to go down fighting. And he's seen the two planes that took our mate Corlun down. Oh, he's got one of them.
Aha!
He's going down fighting to the last second. He's not taking in any rubbish from these guys.
Roger that. Artillery, fire.
It's theoretically possible that an Ostwind and a Panzer 3L could kill an IS-2. I mean, the Panzer 3L with the 50mm, if he's got the best shells, does have decent penetration. Although the shell's not going to do very much damage when it goes through. It's theoretically possible that these two could do it. Ostwinds can be nasty. They've got a 37mm anti-aircraft cannon? I think it's that. 37 or 30. There's the corpse of the P-47 disappearing there. It's really becoming a massive uphill struggle at the moment. There's Gary Tuller. There he is. ET's not seen him. Question is he going to see him in time? Corlun's just camping out behind my wreck of the Tiger, hoping to get some cover. It's not enough though, as Azef returns in his snow camo IS-2. He seems to have got a respawn as well in the IS-2. Good job. And he's right there. Has ET seen him? No, ET's not seen him. Oh dear, he's lost his turret. Well, I guess you can't win them all, but he did get 14 tank kills and 2 air kills from it. So, you can't exactly complain at that. He'd had a beast of a game. Let's look at the scores. I actually came in second in this one with 7 kills for the team and 2 assists. I died 3 times. There's ET Payne up there with his 2 air kills, 14 tank kills, 1 assist, 6 deaths, but then when you get that many points, you earn a lot of respawns, and Colin there with his 2 tank kills. And there's Gary Tuller, 10 kills, 2 deaths, and Azef with 7 kills and 2 deaths. And they're a nice easy game against lower level tanks. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that match and the somewhat sarky commentary on this one, and I'll catch you next time. Have a good one.